the chairman of Vyani Group of Colleges, Rajiv Vyaniji, and Manish Vyaniji, and the director of academics, Mr. Vyaniji. And all the delegates who have come from Japan, academicians, young scientists, and all the students from different disciplines. The topic of the today's discussion and interaction is very important in the global scenario. The impact of Make in India, particularly in the field of technology, is not so simple as we understand. It is of very wide repercussions, and it invites the much labor and vision, and also the intention of different corporate houses and the international governments. It is not so simple as we understand, because it, broadly speaking, it indicates that we are inviting investors from international market, international. What for what purpose? Only for the purpose of manufacturing goods, which will ultimately result in lack of technology, the generation of employment, and the boosting the economic growth of a country. And fourthly, that is the maintaining the equilibrium or the balancing the internet or the world order. So if these four things are to be accomplished intentionally, with good intention, certainly we will accomplish the Make in India mission. So it is not a mission which is unique to India, but it is being liked and adopted by almost all the countries in the international scenario. When we talk of transfer or the sharing of know-how or technology by any country, certainly it should be for the sustainable development. And sustainable development includes the safe and good roads, the green buildings, the mining technology, environment protection, and technology of conveyance, public conveyance, just like different sort of vehicles, and medicine also. When we talk of medicines and technology, without which certainly the economy of the country, particularly in the social welfare scheme, would not be resulting well. For example, I may just cite one important event, that there is one plant in Assam where some juice or extract is just made out of this plant, and it is being sold by India for 60 or 70 rupees per kg. And when this particular juice is just taken out and it is processed and converted to to a medicine to cure the disease of cancer, and it is again bought by us from other countries, then certainly it will cost 4,000 rupees per drop. Now you see the technology, because we don't have the technology, which a small thing can be converted into a very precious thing. Suddenly, this sustainable technology, so far as mining is concerned, the drinking water is concerned, water resource as a technology, different sort of technologies are there, and that, but the countries, the different countries in the world should just be in the responsible that it should be for sustainable development. Nothing else. If sustainable development is not sought out, then we don't think there's any sense in just sharing the technology. So in the case with the generation of employment, because the people from say Japan are here, and they should know that by sharing the technology under the mission, the Make in India mission, is not only useful for India, but for them also. Because no doubt we have got plenty of labor available here, but they are also benefited by having the outsourcing system. Because Japan is a very small country, but it is a technically strong one. Therefore, it has got its own importance in this global scenario. On the other hand, India has got a different diversity which Japan does not have. In this context, we have to say that sharing of technology from Japan and India point of view is very material, and that is to be looked into very seriously and in social context also. Next important thing which should be kept in mind while sharing the technology, whether it is a computer technology or otherwise, that the security and defense strategies, they are very material. Today India may not have that much rich technology in the field of defense and security as Japan has, or other countries have. But certainly, there must be exchange of technology, sharing of technology, so that all the countries who are subjected to this Make in India mission should be benefited. Today, I think the academicians or the professors of different say that their technology is strong, but suddenly we have to see that whether we have to see the technology is meaningful or not, particularly in the social context of each country. So in this context, whether it is a computer science or the industrial technology or the any other technology, we have to say that we have a cooperation between the two countries, and ultimately that will go a long way. With these remarks, because the other speakers are there.
Principal of LBS College to share the stage with his words of wisdom, Dr. Rajiv Srivastava, sir.
Honorable Chief Guest, Professor D.L. Verma sir, delegates from Japan, Rajiv Biyani sir, Sanjay Biyani sir, and educationist and a man of such sense, Dr. Manish Biyani, team of BICON 2015, teaching fraternity, research scholars and my dear students, namaskar. I feel privileged to be part of this august gathering from the field of ITNCL. Our era has observed maximum transformation of the society due to ITNCS professionals. Hats off to the Vedantics world, a beautiful and wonderful place to live in as brothers in this global village. Japan and India are the lands of the rising sun. Youngsters of both the countries are quite energetic and innovative. They are ready to leave their imprints on the sand of the time. This sector has led to massive employment generation. The industry continues to play an important part in employment generation. However, this sector continues to face the challenges of competition in the globalized and modern world. Some of the major areas that present the most pressing challenges of IT professionals are aligning and integrating IT risk management and business continuity capabilities with broader long-term business strategy, managing and strengthening security and privacy for the organization's systems and data is now a top priority across all industries. Effectively organizing, managing and securing growing amounts of data within the organization. Incorporating secure integrated systems for mobile commerce devices, etc., and addressing social media safeguards and strategy with the organization. Technology brings the excitement, helps to look the future, and makes us brave enough to try to shape it. IT does more, IT costs less. Your vision will prepare our future. So, discover the expansion, impact, and challenges in CS and IT in BICON 2015. Thank you for calling me to be a part of this event.